Hello everyone, now let's talk about command injections. So command injections are actually a server-side injection attacks where we try to execute more than one command on a remote server. So what happens is, sometimes a script wants to execute a command on a shell of a remote server. So what a penetration tester can do, so we can try to inject something malicious so that the two commands can be executed parallelly on a remote server. And if we are successfully able to execute our own command on a remote server, then we can do a lot of things like local file inclusion, remote file inclusion. We can upload a shell also. So this command injection vulnerability often found on web applications, which provides functionalities like DNS lookup, IP checks, trace route, and so on. So we can execute multiple commands on that web server if the user input is not sanitized by that web application. Now let's see how we can do command injection attack. Now let's see how command injection works. So here is my OS broken web application up and running. Let's check its IP address. So its IP address is 192.168.0.143. Now let me open this IP address in Firefox so that we can access Mutilidae. So here you can see the menu of OWASP BWA, and let's click on Mutilidae. So in order to access the command injection vulnerable web page, we have to go to OWASP 2013, then injection others, and here you will see the option of command injection. Let's open this page, DNS lookup. So as I told you earlier, that there are some scripts which actually execute some commands on the server. So by looking at this challenge, you will notice that this script asks us for entering the IP or the host name. So if I just enter here google.com and hit enter, so in the result you can see that what this script is doing, and this web page is actually passing a DNS query and just showing us the IP address of google.com. Now, as I told you earlier, that the main motive of command injection is to execute more than one command on a remote server, which actually leads to the remote code execution or even uploading a web shell. So before going further, let me give you a short overview that how we can execute more than one command on any server. So if I just write down here pwd, so here you can see that the pw is one command and here is the output. So what if I want to execute more than one command in one time? So in order to do that, just write down the first command you want to execute, like pwd, followed by the semicolon, then the another command. Let's write down here ls. So this here you can see this semicolon is actually used for executing more than one command. You can say that's also concatenate two commands. Now if I hit enter, here you will see, okay, it's nothing. Okay, I'm doing ls, you can see here. So let's create a demo here, the directory, dir demo, and if I do hit ls, here you can see it's a directory. Now let's execute this command again, pwd and ls. Now if I hit enter, you will notice here that the first our pwd command has been executed. You can see the output slash root, and once the pwd command has been executed, parallelly the ls command also executed, and you can see the directory listing here. So this is the first way to execute more than one command on any server. The another way is we can also execute one or more commands by adding this pipe operator. So if I just add pipe and hit ls, here you will see that this ls command is executed, and you can see the directory here. So this pipe is actually used for executing only one command among the two commands. So in the advanced command injection video series, I'll cover these topics, but for the time being, let's concentrate on this semicolon. Now let's go back to our challenge. So here is the challenge, you can see. Now let's write here google.com, then semicolon. Okay, now let's write here ls. Now if I just hit enter, here you can see that our first command is executed first, DNS lookup, and here you can see the IP, and then after it our ls command is executed on the server, which means we are successfully able to execute more than one command on a remote server, and this kind of attack is called as command injections. So in this video we have covered that what are command injections and how we can execute different commands on a remote server. So thanks for watching this video.